Hi, I'm Blake Lemoyne, and today we're going to talk about Alan Turing and the Turing Test. Can computers ever be intelligent? That's a question that a lot of computer scientists were trying to answer in the middle of the 20th century. They had come to a general process for determining whether or not computers can do something. Step one, formally describe computers. Get a set of equations that describes what a computer can and can't do. Step two, formally describe the problem. Get a set of equations that are very precise and specific about what it is you are asking the computer to do. Step three, put the equations together and make a proof, and prove mathematically whether or not the computer can do that thing. Well, for step one, their primary tool was something called a Turing machine. It was a mathematical description that a man named Alan Turing came up with that says what a computer can do. It's a very simple description. All it is a very long tape and a head that writes on the magnetic tape. It can write a zero, it can write a one, it can move left, it can move right, and that's all a Turing machine can do. Counterintuitively, he was able to prove that this very simple description of a system can do everything which computers can do. Therefore, if the Turing machine can do something, computers can do it. If the Turing machine can't do something, computers can't do it. So, step one was accomplished. Great. Time to move on to step two. What is intelligence? This is where they hit problems. As soon as they tried to mathematically pin down what intelligence is, they realized that none of them agreed about what intelligence is. Everybody wanted to put in their own little thing, saying, oh, this is what intelligence is. And someone else go, oh no, that isn't required for intelligence. That's just something people happen to do. But your definition of intelligence is missing this little part. This debate was largely ended when Alan Turing himself stepped in and wrote an article named Computing Machinery and Intelligence. In this article, he said, hey, you guys are trying to answer the wrong question. You're never going to be able to agree on what intelligence is, so instead of going down that dead end, try to answer whether or not computers can do something that you all agree requires intelligence to do. Now, the task that he offered as the one which requires intelligence to do was something that he called the imitation game. The imitation game is very basically, you have a human judge sitting at a computer terminal chatting with two participants. One of the participants is human, one of the participants is a computer. It's the judge's job to figure out which is which. If the computer can reliably convince a large number of judges that it's the person, then that system is intelligent. Now, one thing that's important to note, the computer can't rely on some kind of weird trick, because as soon as the judge learned what the weird trick was, it would then be able to reliably identify the computer participant. So, this test has been more or less accepted as a good benchmark for what is and isn't intelligent. No computer has ever passed the Turing test. However, there are several very well-funded efforts in Silicon Valley heading towards that goal. Elon Musk's OpenAI is only the newest addition to the group, which, by the way, if you're interested in contributing to the open source project, OpenAI, there's a link down below. Not everyone believes that the Turing test would be the best test for intelligence. Some people maintain that a computer program could rely on some kind of trick that would reliably fool judges even if they knew what it was. Other people maintain that there's a wide variety of things required for intelligence beyond just having a conversation. So they would want a test that employs a lot of different kinds of intelligence skills. Personally, there's an alternative that I like a lot. It was proposed by a computer scientist named Ben Goertzel. This alternative is really simple to describe. Send an intelligent robot to college, and if it comes back with a degree, it's intelligent. This robot would need to be able to do its homework, participate in group discussions, contribute to group projects, study new material, and prove on tests that it had learned how to do it. It would probably even have to write a poem or two every now and again. There's one task that people tend to gloss over, though, that everyone has to accomplish if they're going to get a degree. And I personally have watched a decent number of people struggle with this task, so I know that our AI would have to somehow overcome it. And it'll provide the topic for our next discussion. How would our AI pick a major? Until then, I'm Blake LeMoyne. Have fun and go create something.